Nicole, and I want to thank you for tuning in to Sip and Spill, the pregnancy edition. Yes, I am pregnant. I have a bun in the oven. So I would like to call this like my whole segment for the rest of my month, the pregnant version. And I'll get into more detail on why I named it the pregnant version. But also, I can go by Rocky Nicole, the version. Like, if you ever seen Jane, the version, then you know exactly what I'm talking about. How she was a virgin and then ended up pregnant. Voila! Human form. You know what I'm saying? Like, real life. Right here. But, yeah, so I'm gonna just give y'all a little background about myself for those who don't know me. I go by Rocky Nicole. Also, I recently just graduated from college, Prairie View A&M University, Panther, and I graduated in computer engineering with a minor in mass communication. I was in school, to me, forever. It was time to go. I graduated from college in month of July. I got pregnant. Thought I was grown. I mean, I am grown, but you know, I thought I was grown, you know, and it was just, I can honestly say the summer of 2019 had really took a toll on my life. I took a toll on my life. But pregnancy is always a blessing. A bundle of joy here. I might not look like I'm pregnant, but I'm going to just let you know I'm 5 months. Hello, this is Hayden My Fizz, but you could call me Big Mom. I am 5 months pregnant, and it's an experience. I'm going to just go ahead and run it down to you. So like I said, I got pregnant in the month of July. I always had a feeling I was pregnant, so I was like, I got a feeling I'm pregnant. You know, most females have the feeling that they're pregnant, they miss their period, and it's like, let me take a test. Well, for me, it was different, you know? So, first off, I didn't have a period every month. So, when I missed my period, it was like, I catch you next month. It's cool. I ain't even tripping, you know what I'm saying? But this time, you know, I can say that before because I wasn't joining the reindeer games. You know what I'm saying? Since I didn't got in the reindeer games, I couldn't play that. I couldn't say that no more. So when I missed that period, I was like, you need to take them tests. And then I took them tests. So I told my significant other that I think I'm pregnant. I think I need to take a pregnancy test. And he went and got the test for me. And it was, I do number watch television. My favorite show is Martin. So on the episode of Martin when Gina thought she was pregnant, that was me. Voila. Magic. So Gina in the restroom trying to figure it out. I'm in the restroom trying to figure it out. Really illiterate to it all. And I'm on the phone. I had to call my cousin and my friend because it was the only two people who knew I was pregnant. And I was like, I'm about to take a pregnancy test. I think I'm pregnant. And I didn't know what to do. And don't laugh at me. But I was going like a tampon that was going to be that pregnancy test. And my friend was like, nah, you don't do it like that. So she told me to pee in the cup, and on the box, if it's this line, you're not pregnant. But when that mud started adding, you pregnant. So, mine started adding. First, I'm getting this line. I'm like, okay, cool. And then this line started coming. It started itching in, and I'm like, I'm pregnant. I'm pregnant. And then, you know, so I was like, just to be on the safe side, I'm going to go ahead and dip it up, doing up in there. And if it's pink, you're pregnant. If it's nothing, then you're not. Well, mine wasn't only pink. It was hot pink. You know, it wasn't no pastel or nothing. It was hot pink. Like, yeah, you're pregnant. Stop playing because you already knew that. So that was, that's what it was. When I found out I was pregnant, only two people knew, and my significant other. He called and told his people. And later on that day, I did like a presentation for my mom and my dad. Well, in the presentation, I let my friend present it to her, my mom, because she has a child. So it was, in the presentation, it was like a little poem. And on the back of the poem, it was the pregnancy. So it was, the poem was, "Roses are red, violets are blue. Thank you for being a great grandmother to my child, but this one is actually for you." So she looking at her, like my mama looking at her like, "You pregnant?" She talking about, "No, not me." So she eased her way on down the road and I'm like, "Hello, this is Hattie Mae Pierce, but you can call me pregnant mama." You know what I'm talking about? So I was like, "Yeah, I'm pregnant." And she said, "Wait, for real?" I said, "Yeah, I'm pregnant." The whole time, my significant other just over there playing like he's asleep. But it was like a, what? You know, my mama's so dramatic. So, but then I waited, and when my daddy got there, my cousin presented it to him. So she read the poem to him, and when she finished, he looking at her like, "What?" And she looking at him like, "Nah, don't look at me." So you know what he do? He's himself on down the road. And I'm like, "You're about to be a granddad." And he was like, "Conference." That's what he did to my mama. He rubbed it right there and said, "Conference." You know, when I first told him, didn't nobody believe me because I played so many games. It was like, "Girl, stop playing. You ain't pregnant." Like, even when my brother walked in the house, I was like, "So you gotta wash the dishes because I can't because I'm pregnant." He said, "Man, stop playing." I said, "Real talk." I had to pull the sticks out of my purse and I showed it to him. He was like, "I'm finna be your uncle." You know, a baby in our family is a beautiful thing. You know, we just grasped to children. So when I told him, he was excited. I mean, everybody at the same time was shocked because it was me. So I had some excitement and I had some non-excitement. And, you know, I'm going to let my good outweigh the bad. And if you're not with me, if you wasn't with me in the beginning, if you're not with me now, don't be with me in the end. And then it's period. And that's just how I roll. Because, you know, I need you to be 100%. I don't need your 50 and your 75. Mm-mm. Because this journey here for me, if you really just know me, is too much. And for me, it was like, I'm as ready as I can be. You know what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, I am happy. It took me a minute to get there. First off, it was surreal. I didn't even believe I was pregnant. Well, I almost told the months that I was pregnant. I went in my first doctor visit. I went to the doctor. And that doctor, well, the nurse let my mama know she pregnant. And my mama said, "We know she pregnant." But I started spotting. So I was like, and you know, when you go on Google just let you know you got everything. You say you're spotting, Google want to let you know you got cancer. That ain't even the case. So I had to go ahead and called up an OBGYN and make my appointment. And they had to go up inside me and see what was up in there. So my first trimester was an experience. I told one of my grandmothers, damn near cursed me out. I told another one of my grandmothers. She said, "About time." So, you know, it's crazy. I had waited, and I told my cousins, my girl cousins, they were all excited. And then I told my boy cousin, one of my cousins, he stopped messing with me. The rest of my cousins, they're happy for me. But, you know, everybody else is happy. Either you're happy or you're not. I told some friends, they didn't, or associates, they didn't respond. I told some other ones, they did respond. I told social media, it got passed around 50-some times, you know. For you, one minute you're a virgin, the next minute you're pregnant, we gotta send this out like mail. You know what I'm talking about? Everybody gotta get it. And that's just what it was. So, it was crazy. But it's life. You know what I'm saying? It was gonna happen. It just happened sooner than I expected. Sooner than my people expected. But I'm happy. Him is a boy. So, and that's the crazy thing is I've always said before I actually started playing reindeer games that I wanted my first child to be a boy because I always wanted my oldest to be a boy and then my second to be a girl and then so on, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. But I always wanted my daughter to have a big brother. You know what I'm saying? So, I'm having a boy, I was excited. Like, I wasn't a disappointment. Like, oh, man. And if you really know me, then you know a boy is what I need. At least my first child. You know what I'm talking about? And then, you know, as I grow, then I can teach my daughter, you know. But my first child, I needed that to be a boy. But if it was a girl, I would have been happy too. I mean, who wouldn't want a mini me? But yeah, my pregnancy experience, like all the way up to my 5 months right now, has really been a roller coaster. But I'll let y'all know about that in my next segment. So I want to thank y'all for tuning in to the pregnant version. Again, my name is Rocky Nicole. Peace.